Major funding for GreenLife Pennsylvania is provided by
the Pennsylvania Department of Conservation and Natural Resources, inspiring citizens to explore the outdoors and practice conservation. Learn more about how you can help conserve our natural resources at www.iconservepa.org.
Turn it on with green power. Preparing for winter by saving electricity and money is the mission of these two auditors.
We do energy audits, primarily residential. It surprises people to find out when we tell them to allow 3 or 4 hours for a full energy audit, because in the past, maybe somebody's walked through with a clipboard and said, oh, you need to do this, that, and the other thing. Our energy audits are based on building science and diagnostic testing. We walk through, we make notes on different kinds of lights or different kinds of extension cords. We include the blower door, which draws air out of the home so that we can see where air is leaking in. What we've done is install an aluminum frame in the opening for the front door, and then over that frame we've put a shroud to help block out as much of the air as possible. One of the tools that we use for this is called an infrared thermographer or an infrared camera. The lower temperatures are shown with purple and blue. The higher temperatures are shown with yellow and red. As you can see here, the openings where there's some air coming through from the outside tend to be more blue and purple. What this fan will do is pull air from the house, not just from this immediate first floor area, but all the way up into the other rooms and from the basement below. We use a depressurization so that the air is being pulled out of the house. Once we have the fan at a stable speed and the pressure flow is pretty regular, then we'll go for a walk around the house so that we can see where the cold air is coming in. Even though these are pretty new windows, there is some dark purple color around the edge, which indicates that there's cold air coming in. That air is probably not coming from the window itself, but from gaps between the window and the wall. So the homeowner would have an opportunity to do some air sealing to keep that infiltration out. One of the things that homeowners can do that's pretty easy and inexpensive is, wherever possible, to convert their standard incandescent lights over to compact fluorescent bulbs that use about a quarter of that energy and last up to 10 times longer. Even through the shade, that light bulb is putting out temperature that brings up to about 90 degrees. Now, it's not too much of a problem during the winter, but the summer, when you're trying to keep the house cool, you're working against those incandescent lights. Well, the kitchen's an interesting place for an energy auditor. There are a whole lot of things, good and bad, that can happen here. And the good news is it's one of the places where the homeowner has the most control and ability to improve things. This electrical outlet, you can feel a little bit of cold air coming in from behind. You can see it looks almost like two little faces. And you'll notice that in where the eyes and mouth would be, it's a bluer color, which means that the air that's coming through there is colder. Well, this is a really simple solution. You remove the faceplate, you caulk around the edge, and then you put this foam cutout piece right over there, and then put the cover back on. That will reduce the amount of air that is leaking. The fireplace is often the most beautiful part and a favorite part of the house. It's also one of the places that is most likely to have problems with outside air coming through. This fireplace is a good example. Even though the damper is closed and they have glass doors here, we can still see cold air leaking through this crack. In fact, with the fan on, the air is blowing the doors open. If it's a fireplace that doesn't get used very often, there are products that you can insert in the chimney that will keep the air from drafting through. They're wonderful and warm to look at, but in many, many cases, they actually cost you more energy than you benefit from the heat. One thing many Americans may not realize is that up to a third of their electric use ends up as what we call phantom power. There are two outlets plugged into the wall, the upper one for an iPod charger. Both of them are attracting heat. The reason that we're showing this is because the iPod charger is not connected to anything. So even when it's not doing its job of recharging the iPod, it is still drawing a considerable amount of electricity. what we find in general is that the top priority in most homes are the leaks and creaks that let little bits of air in at a time. And so the most effective thing normally that people can do for their return on investment is actually to be caulking and sealing.
Have you had an energy audit done on your home? Tell us about it. Visit greenlifepenn.org.